over here, that is basic components of a computer, just a run through. If we had studied input devices, a keyboard, just go through them. Just press escape and quickly move through all those. So we had seen all the input devices, joystick and everything, and we were over here, that is hard disk, auxiliary storage. So we had to see it from here. So this is how a hard disk looks like. So I had already shared this with you. Everything is compacted within a hard disk pack. These are the tracks, that is the concentric circles which cover the hard disk platter. And these are divided into sectors. Circles, these concentric circles are known as the donut shaped circles are known as tracks. And this is known as a sector. Now your magnetic disk is covered with small magnetic grains, okay? And a group of these grains, they form what? Bit area. That is, you can store individual, that is, this one whole group can represent one bit. This will be representing the second bit, third bit, fourth, fifth, and so on. So this represents a bit, and because it contains magnetic grains, these magnetic grains have magnetic properties and they align themselves in any fashion. Right now they are aligned in any fashion. When electricity or magnetic field is provided to them, they will align in a particular direction, somewhat like this. So aligning in one direction can be considered as one bit, and aligning in the opposite direction can be considered as zero bit. So you can see how by using electricity or magnetism, they can be aligned. And this is how data is written onto your hard disk. You can see it over here. Sometimes, now that is not required. Now see how data is written. So this just goes on, this read or write head makes use of, it has, you can see it has an electric coil surrounding it. So it creates a magnetic field which aligns these small magnetic bits, these bits in a particular direction. North, south, this is considered as one, south, north is considered as zero. Then we have CD, which is also known as optical media. It is quite inexpensive. Storage capacity is up to 700.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, in the test, is it compulsory to give the same email ID that we have given in the unit test?
Ma'am, you have to you have to give a valid email ID which you use often and from, because your test result will be sent to that. Now in
yes,
Microsoft
but...
Teams, wait. You do not, on the Microsoft platform, you do not need to enter your email ID because your name would be taken from there. Okay. You may, and automatically the result also you will get through Microsoft Teams only.
Okay.
Shall we start the class, students? I would appreciate if you don't interrupt me in between. Okay. CD-ROM. CDR, that is CD recordable and CD rewritable. CD-ROMs are what? They are already manufactured by the companies with pre-recorded data. like video CD or movie CD or audio CD, okay, or any encyclopedia CD. So all those things, all those CD-ROMs, they are known as CD-ROMs. That is CD read-only memory. You purchase them and you just read them, okay? You cannot write anything on them. Second is CD recordable. That is purchase a blank CD from the market, write your own data and then use it. Now that is what write once, read many. You cannot, I'll just explain that. It will be, this is what recordable. That is write once, read multiple times. Okay, and this is CD rewritable. You bring a blank CD, it is a bit costlier than CD recordable, and you can write it multiple times and you can even rewrite. That is, you can delete the contents or remove the previous contents and rewrite new values. Next is how data is read from a CD. So look over here. CD surface, it is covered with pits and lands. Somewhat, it is like this. You can see a laser emitter. There is a mirror, another mirror. This is a lens. And you can see pits and lands. Can you see that? See this? This is how it appears. These are pits and lands. And this is how your laser beam is focused on them. And it is reflected back in a particular manner. So this is how data is read from it. And the reflected light, it goes into a sensor which actually interprets them in the form of ones and zeros. Okay, so you have pits and lands. This is how it is. There is a protective acrylic. You can just understand this as a cross section of a CD. Right? So this is your CD surface. This is the actual aluminium coating. This is the aluminium layer which contains your data. Above this and below this, you have protective layer, protective acrylic layer and polycarbonate plastic layer. This is a land. If you just see it like this, it appears as an elevated area, hence it is land, okay? And this is a pit. This is a pit. Ek gaddha khuda hua hai, aisa lag raha hai, okay? So this is a pit and this is a land. And this is how laser is focused on it and it is reflected back in a particular fashion. Now, how ones and zeros are interpreted? Look at it very carefully. So this is your CD surface with pits and lands. Light goes and it is reflected. Again, it is reflected. So you can see something over here that when there is a pit over here, when there is a transition between a land and pit. So light is focused in a certain way and it is reflected differently. Whereas if the surface is flat like this, if it's a continuous surface, if there is no intersection between land and pit, here there is an intersection between land and pit, but here there is no intersection between land and pit. The light is focused on a continuous area, that is on the land. So here the light which is incident, the light which is focused over here, it will be reflected in the same manner. So with this, we can understand that these are zeros. But jahan pe bhi ye change ho raha hai, that is here it is focused on a certain manner, but reflected in a different manner. That means here it is considered as one. Whereas here it is considered as continuous pattern of zeros. More you can understand over here. Pits and lands, okay. This is how laser beam is getting focused. This is how the laser travels on it. So you can see over here, reflected wave from pit area and reflected wave from flat area called land. So when you see this, it is these two lights which are reflected, they are different. This one is different from this one. So one can be considered as, this can be considered as one, and this can be considered as zero. So this is how it happens. Take a look. See, this is zero. Wherever it changes, one. And again zero, wherever it changes, one. And again zero, then again one. Understood. So this is how data is read as well as recorded. Okay. It is already recorded because you can see the pits and lands over here, and how it is read in this manner. Wherever it finds a transition from transition between pit and land, at those places it will be one, and other continuous places it will be zero. Now this you don't have to learn, students. This I just provided as an extra knowledge to you. You should understand, you should know how it works. You might be curious how data is stored and how data is read. So for that purpose only, I have created this. Next is DVD. It holds 15 times data as compared to CD, 20 times faster data transfer, also called super density disk or SD. Up to 17 GB of data can be held in a DVD. There are two types, DVD recordable, DVD rewritable. And DVD ROMs also you can get. Some DVD capacities you can see over here. This is single sided, single layer, one side and one layer. So 4.7 GB of data can be held. Single sided but double layer, two layers you can see over here. Sorry, so 8.5 GB and double sided double layer, 17 GB of data could be there. Next is a Blu-ray disc. It is a next generation optical disc developed by Blu-ray Disc Association, that is BDA, a group of world's leading consumer electronics, PC and media manufacturers, including Apple, Dell, Hitachi, HP, JVC, LG, Mitsubishi, Panasonic, Philips. They all have together contributed to creating a Blu-ray disc. So normally a Blu-ray disc is something, I'm not going into the details of it. This is a Blu-ray disc. Okay. And the way it reads data, you can see how data is compacted. More data is, you can see more pits and lands in a small area. Okay. So that means this is what a CD looks like. Less number of pits and lands in an area, little more, that is DVD, and more closely packed, that is your Blu-ray disc. It enables recording, rewriting, playback of HD videos, storing large amounts of data, five times the storage capacity of traditional DVDs. It can hold up to 25 to 50 GB on a single layer disc, and on a dual layer disc, there could be 50 to 100 GB. Use of advanced audio and video codec. Codec means it's a kind of an encoding technique which can be used for playing audio, different types of audio and video formats. Usually there are many video formats, MKV, MP4. You might have seen them. The usual one is MP4, which is the most popular. Apart from that, you have MKV, okay. Then you have a WMV format also. Then you have MPEG. MPEG-2 format also. So various other formats are there. So it can, these different advanced codecs can support multiple formats, more formats than the previous versions. Use of blue violet laser for read and write, which has a shorter wavelength. So blue violet laser is used for read and write operations. These days, you can get Blu-ray disc up to 128 GB capacity. Next is pen drive. There are multiple names for a pen drive: thumb drives, flash memory, USB memory, key memory, solid state memory. This is most important, students. SSD, you might have heard about this, solid state drives. There are SSD hard drives also, which are becoming very popular these days. They are around 10,000 times faster than your usual SATA hard disk drives. No moving parts, no lasers used as removable drives, cell phones. Okay, used in cell phones a lot, works like RAM. And sizes 256 MB to 128 GB and even beyond that. Session 4, operating system. Now, let us try to understand that operating system by taking the case of a manager in a restaurant. So what does the restaurant manager do? He controls how order is taken, how order is processed, how order is served, how bill is generated, everything. He manages the complete working of the restaurant. So the waiter takes the order. The cook prepares the order. Waiter serves the order. And the cashier generates the bill. Right? So right from the beginning, you can see every activity is controlled by the manager. So operating system also works similar to this, like it controls how input is received, how request is processed, how order is displayed, how print is generated. Keyboard takes the input. Okay. CPU processes the request. Monitor displays the output. And printer prints the output. So you can finally get the output. So all this is handled by your operating system. So operating system is just like a driver for your computer. Without the operating system, your computer cannot work. Let me ask you all a very simple question, students. Suppose anyone purchases a new, Ananya Tiwari, let me ask it to you only. Ananya, are you there? Ananya Tiwari? Yes. Give me a response, hello or anything. Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
So let me ask you a question. Suppose Ananya, one day, in someday in the future, she decides to purchase a new car. Okay. Now she purchases the new car, but she doesn't know how to drive. What will you do? You want to take your family to an outing, a local sightseeing in your new car. What will you do? You don't know driving. None of your family members know how to drive. So what would you do?
Hello.
Ma'am, we would hire a driver.
Very good. You would hire a driver. That is, you would hire someone who knows how to drive. Got it? So that person would be acting as an interface. Kartik Tripathi, please keep your mic mute. So that driver will know how to drive the car. So that driver would be able to take you to different places. Similarly, you purchase your computer from the market and one second. You purchase your computer from the market and you just bring it. Is it going to start working? Answer is no. You have to install an operating system first. And then only on that you can install any application software like MS Office and start working on it. Okay. So operating system is like a driver for your computer. Kartik, is there any problem with your mic? Why are you unmuting yourself again and again? It's causing a lot of disturbance here. an operating system is the most important system software. It is a set of programs that control and supervise the hardware of a computer, provides services to application software, programmers and users, manages all hardware and software, input, output, processing activities within the computer system, flow of information to and from the processor, sets priorities for handling different tasks, and so on. So these red colored lines will give you an insight into what all work, what all things an operating system does for your computer, right from managing all the hardware, all the software, right from managing the tasks which are being carried out. It performs all type of tasks. Some screenshots. Disk operating system. It was an CUI, that is character user based operating system. Character user interface. That is CUI based operating system, which was used when we didn't have these multimedia computers. We had monochrome computers, and ours is a generation who have actually worked on such computers. Okay, so we used to have a computer, there was no mouse attached to it. So all work was done using the keyboard only. So we had to remember commands, we had to memorize commands to work on such operating systems. Unix is also another CUI, that is character user based operating system, where you had to remember commands, but it is a different platform. Linux is a GUI form of Unix only. So you can see the Linux desktop over here. It's another operating system. And this penguin, its name is Tux. You have seen when you were small, young, you learned Tux Paint. Do you remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Tux is the official mascot of Linux and all the open source GNU based projects. Okay, official mascot of all Linux based softwares. Understood? So it's the official mascot for Linux. So Tux Paint is a small paint application, an open source application. Understood? So which you can download very easily and you can draw and paint in that. Solaris, this is another operating system, and it is also kind of Linux based. Its interface is that it looks like that of Linux, as well as it resembles Mac OS also. Then you have iOS, Android. These all are operating systems. Now, why do you need operating system? Because it provides a platform on top of which application programs can run. Acts as an interface between the computer and the user. One second, let me take the attendance, students. Operates, controls, and executes various applications on the computer, allows the computer to manage its own resources such as memory, monitor, keyboard, printer, etc. Introduction to desktop environment of OS. Desktop environment means, suppose you have your tabletop. You will decide upon the type of tablecloth which you want, the type of design which you want, okay, where you want to keep your computer, where you'll be keeping all your books. You might also want to have a small shelf containing all your accessories like your pen, pencil, eraser, ruler, all those things, right? So it's up to you how to decide how your desktop, your tabletop should look like. So similarly, we have different desktop environments. Like this is the Linux desktop, you can see. Just see, it's an animated image, okay, of a Linux desktop, specifically Ubuntu. So you can just see what all is being done on the screen. You can type command here, you can save files. This is Gedit, which is a small notepad-like application, a text editor of Ubuntu Linux. Okay. Next is Linux desktop of BOSS, Bharat Operating System Services, which is created by, actually they did not create, they downloaded the source code of Linux. We know that Linux is an open source operating system. So you can download its program, make changes, and you can re-release it by your own name. So its full form is Bharat Operating System Services or Solutions. And this has been created by CDAC Pune. It is actually Center for, one second. Center for Development of Advanced Computing. So they have personalized this Linux operating system for use by Indians and various Indian languages. It provides support for Indian languages. But unfortunately, we rely only on English language. That's a different story. Okay, components of desktop environment. So we can see some components which you can see on your desktop, not only on Windows, but any other operating system. Like here, you can see a window manager. And here, the screenshot which you are seeing, that is of Linux, not of Windows. Some panels you might have, quick launch panel, like this is a panel which is taken from Microsoft Windows 10 operating system. So quick launch panel can be also used. Like next is system tray. So at the corner, bottom right corner, you can see a system tray which contains some icons showing some certain things like volume, language, network connection, okay, any other application which is running in the background. Panels menu, you can see some panels menu if it contains shortcuts to certain applications. Then menus, you can see menus over here. Then applications, places, system, you can see application. These are the menus. This is specifically in Linux operating system, students. Okay, so in Linux you will see and this Linux which is shown over here, that is Debian. Linux has multiple distributions: Red Hat Linux, Fedora Linux, Mandrake Linux. I'll just type their names: Red Hat Linux, Fedora, Mandrake. Then Mint and so on. So many different distributions. They are known as distributions of Linux. Linux operating system. Okay. And so here you can see that you can open applications from here. Go to app, just like you start your, click your start menu. So it will open the start menu. Similarly on Linux operating system, you click on applications and you will be getting an access to all this. So you can individually check what all things, what all options are there in each one of them. Next is menus. So this, you can get different menus also, and this you already know. Next is widgets. Students, in the offline lecture which I have uploaded very recently, that is yesterday, the one which was uploaded, I have explained widgets in great detail. Okay, widgets are also known as gadgets. Okay. Desktop gadgets. and those gadgets could be related to, you can watch, you can see the time, you can use calendar, gadget, you can have an analog clock gadget. Understood. So various different type, even weather, checking the weather gadget, all of them could be there. Like, for example, in Windows 10, you don't have anything like gadgets. You, because all these type of what gadgets could were doing in the previous versions, all those are added as apps over here. So like, for example, this one is the gadget for weather. If I click on this, you will be seeing weather. Just a sec. So right now it's taking some time to open. So once it opens, you can see the weather. And this is how it is. You can add them as widgets on your desktop, either on your mobile phone or on your computer, and use them. Then you have a file manager. Normally, you might have seen, have you seen this file manager on your mobile phones? You have a small app known as File Manager or Google Files, from yes, where ma'am. You can access all yes, the ma'am. Files which are stored on your smartphone. And here we have a File Explorer. This is a File Explorer from where we can access all our files, right? So every operating system will have its own file manager. Next is a browser. Browser, if you want to open something, you can easily click on the open button. Like I press Control O, I'll have to first escape. And now if I press Control O, it will open this. I can go to browse. This is a browser, understood, which allows me to browse through or open any file on my computer. So same way here, you can see the browser in an Ubuntu system. This is the browser for Windows. This one is for Windows. And this is for your Ubuntu Linux. Next is Office Suite. Every operating system would have its own Office Suite. Like for Microsoft Windows, we normally use what? Microsoft Office, right? Similarly, you have other Office Suites like OpenOffice.org, LibreOffice, right? ThinkOffice. On your mobiles, you have WPS Office. This is a Chinese app which is banned in India now, okay? So you can also use Google Office Suites like Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides.
Classroom.
And all. Google Classroom is not Office. It doesn't come under Office Suite, okay? I'm only talking about softwares like these. Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, OneNote, OneDrive. These all are MS Office product. You will have a text editor like Notepad, or in Ubuntu, you can have a text editor like Vim. Vim VI editor, or Vim is a text editor for Ubuntu. Okay, then this is another text editor like Gedit. Its name is Gedit. Then you can have a terminal like here. You can have command prompt, CMD if I type. This is command prompt, right? You can provide any command like dir. You can see the direct, all the folders over here. Right. Similarly, you can have terminals in various operating system. Like this is the terminal for Mac OS. Understood. This is another terminal. Display manager. Display manager, which handles all the displays on your system. Like we also have it for Windows. some two popular Linux desktop we'll see. One is, now this was all about what we studied till display manager was all about the various components of any operating system, any GUI operating system, that is graphical user interface operating system. Got it? So let us see two popular Linux desktop, that is two popular flavors, you can say, or two popular styles of Linux desktop. One of them is GNOME desktop environment. It's like this. And another one is K desktop environment, that is KDE. Okay. So these are two very popular desktop environments. If you are using Linux, then you can easily download or install the GNOME or K desktop environment and use whichever one you are comfortable with. Linux desktop basic icons. So here you can see the icons. This is computer. Normally we have it as this PC on Windows. Okay. Home means you can have your documents. Like here I have Gargi PC. You can see at the top, right? Let me show it to you. I'm going to the desktop. And this is it. You can see Gargi PC. Okay. So this thing is given over here in this way. The user's documents are there in this. Trash is for recycle bin. And this could represent any partition on your hard disk. Some common desktop operations. Now, this session 5, I have uploaded a video on YouTube, students. So I hope you have you seen that? Anybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Please watch that video because I have explained everything in detail over there. So some desktop operations like adding icons to the desktop. So how do you add icons to the desktop? Let's see over here. So for this, we need to first right click on the desktop and we need to select what? Personalize. One second, students, let me switch on the my laptop is low on power. So I just switched on the electricity. So here you can see the personalize option. So here in personalize, you have to go to the right hand side and you have to go to themes first. And from here, you can go to desktop icon settings. So when you click on that, you will get desktop icons. Right now, all these icons are checked. If I just uncheck them and click on OK, if I click on OK, you can see that all those icons are removed. So you need to go back again, click on desktop icons, click on select all of these, click on OK. Go back and you can see all those icons have come back. Right. Next is hiding desktop icons. Now, how do you hide desktop icons? So for this, we will just go to the desktop, right click on the desktop, and from here go to view and uncheck this, that is show desktop icons. So if I uncheck this, all the icons are gone. Again, you want them back, right click, go to view, click on show desktop icons, and all the icons will reappear on your desktop. So students, it's time up. So we are going to end the class over here and get ready for your test at 11 a.m. Okay. I'm stopping the share, stopping the recording. Okay.